Speaking of someone who is self-employed and very much in the business of information as we are, is Scott Jones. He's from a website that those of us in the industry read regularly, and we log on there, those of us who are in the business, and we just pray that we're not the subject of an article. FTVLive.com has become, over 20 years, like the go-to site for a little gossip, analysis, and information about what's happening in local television all across the country. Scott Jones is joining us now from his world headquarters in Jacksonville, Florida, looking like a boss this morning. Good morning, Scott.
How's it going, guys?
I'm pretty good. How are you is the question. I mean, it looks like you're hunkered down there underground, just in case.
I'm in the tunnel.
You're in the tunnel, just
sure
in case.
Are.
Is there a light at the end of that tunnel?
There is a light at the end of the tunnel.
Oh, wow.
It's way down there.
Okay.
And I think that's what we're looking at. I think we got a long way to go, but I think there will be a light at the end of the tunnel. And I think when we come out of this, we're all going to be changed, no question about it.
Yes, we are.
I think a lot of us will be changed in good ways and probably healthier.
You know, it's funny you say that, because I realize I've lived in Dallas for 10 years and I've never walked in Dallas, like gone outside and walked for the sake of exercise. Now, I have walked between bars. I've gotten out of my car and walked into a restaurant. But when I work out, I go to the gym. But this is not a walking town. And now the streets are flooded with families and their dogs and their children. And everyone's keeping their distance, but they're saying hi to each other. And there is, in the midst of this chaos and uncertainty, something about that and the humanity of it that I think made me feel really good.
Yeah, and the same thing's happening here. I go out, I take my dog out several times a day, and I see people everywhere walking their dogs. I see families riding their bikes together. I never saw that prior to this.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just amazing. You're getting, you know, the families around the dinner table again, which is, it's incredible. So I really, this is terrible. Don't get me wrong. This is awful. Yeah. But I think when it is all over, just like past generations that dealt with, World War I, World War II, and everything else, I think we're going to come out of this as a better generation.
How are our local news stations in their various markets doing, do you think, overall in covering this for their communities?
I think local news is doing very well. I look at, I put a poll on my site today, and it was talking about the trust of the national media. And, it's probably no surprise that Republicans trust the national media. I think it was 13 or 14%. And Democrats trust the national media. It was like 80%. And, when you have the president that's constantly calling the lamestream media and attacking the media, it certainly has hurt, I think, the national media. But local media, I think, is robust. I think it's changing. I think they are finally realizing, this is what we're supposed to do.
This is
because
our purpose.
Even local media had changed dramatically. What mm-hmm. You were putting comedians on the air. You were putting, you were doing Facebook on your newscast. It wasn't really news. And now they're going back to the roots of local news, and people are tuning into local news. So I think it's huge. And I think when people attack the media, the one thing you don't understand, if you took cable news out of the game, you got Fox News way over on the right, you got MSNBC and CNN way over on the left, and people don't trust cable news, and there's a good reason for it, because really, unless you want to live in your echo chamber, that's where you're going to tune in. But if you took cable news out of the equation, I think people really trust the national news more, taking away cable news, and local news a lot more.
That's good to know for the local news business.
Yeah. Scott, this is Yolanda here. I wanted to ask, what do you think about supporting the newsrooms and giving lunch to the newsrooms?
Yeah, because that's something you've done, Scott. You decided last week that you were going to pick a newsroom a day randomly across the country, and you were going to serve them up lunch. And in fact, that's what inspired me to reach out to you to say, what a great gesture that is.
Yeah, well, you know what? It's not gone as well as I thought. It did at first.
Why?
Because if you send I'm still doing it, and what I'm now doing is sending these meals to journalists that are locked in their houses and stuff like that. Because what happens is, I sent a pizza to a station in Richmond on Monday, and then the last few days I've been sending it to individual journalists locked in. Mm-hmm. I did talk to a general manager in Austin, Texas, and I wanted to send her newsroom some food, and she said the problem is, there's not that many people in the building anymore. Uh-huh. And second of all, they're not allowed to have a community food like pizza where people gather around. So what I've been doing is picking journalists that are at home. I sent a woman, yesterday, Chipotle with her. She was locked home with her kids and everything else. And the idea was to kind of say thank you. But the other idea was, you know, you sit here and you go, what can I do? You know, what can I do as an individual? And, you know, I thought by calling around to different restaurants around the country and spending a few dollars, and believe me, it's a few dollars. I mean, I think the pizza was like $75. The Chipotle was $45 or $50, whatever. Not a lot of money. But the idea that you could spend a little bit of money in a different community and try and help these businesses out. And the only thing I've said to these stations or the people that I send it to is tip the delivery person really well.
Yeah.
You're getting a free meal, and that changes that person's life at least for a couple hours if you can give them money. And so far, that's worked out great. I mean, I think I paid, I think it was $48 for Chipotle, and the reporter that I sent it to, she tipped the guy $50.
Oh, that's amazing. Cool.
That is amazing. Yeah.
Nice to hear.
You know, so really, it's what can you do?
So even though logistically it's not as smooth as you'd hope, the sentiment is certainly there, and maybe others will be inspired by that. Some of those newsrooms might have thought, is Scott Jones trying to poison us with his food? Because you can be, and rightly so, you're in your lane here in criticizing some of the way that stations have covered things in the past. There's one thing, there's one point of contention that you talk about a lot on your site, and I'm in agreement with you about this. And I want to ask you what it is, because I've written down on a piece of paper what I think it is, and it's printed here and folded. There's one beef that you have with a new generation of young journalists coming through the ranks, and I want you to tell me what it is.
Well, I think the way you phrase that question, I think it is the selfies and what they do with the selfies. And, you know, people will take a picture of them at a crime scene. You know, there's crime scene but tape behind them, and they're smiling and saying, oh, here covering, you know, this awful murder. And they're smiling and going.
Or they're saying, which dress should I wear? And they're at a crime scene. And that is called, Scott, all about.
There it is.
It's called All About Me Journalism. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Nailed it.
And that's what I call it. I call it All About Me TV. And that's what it is. That's what the selfies are. That is what, I mean, people, there was one, I just saw a reporter that said, oh, I've been so busy and so tired this week, been hanging out at the governor's office. He included four pictures of him, nothing else, just four pictures of him on different days of the week wearing a different shirt at the governor's office, and saying, I'm so tired, but, you know, I'm doing such an important job. And journalists are doing an important job. But you know what? The doctors and the nurses,
they're around the clock,
doing an important job. And I don't see them posting these selfies saying, oh, I'm so exhausted and everything.
Yeah,
do your job.
I saw a producer posting about, I had such a rough day today and spent X number of hours in the booth. And I thought, well, you're not in a hospital, A. B, your life's not on the line, and C, you're still working when others are being downsized and laid off. So let's hope, Scott, as local newsrooms come back to doing what it is their purpose and mission was meant to be in the beginning, and that is providing valuable information at a time of need. Let's hope that journalists understand that it's really not about them. It's about telling the stories of other people.
Absolutely.
And thank you for doing what you do by covering it, even though, like I tell you, I've gripped my teeth a couple of times when I'm like, oh, he's writing about me. Lord.
Well, I think in the end of this, it's going to be for journalism. It's going to be I think this is going to thin the herd a little bit. I think we're going to the journalists that have lived through this, worked through this and everything else, realize this is what I want to do. And the people that said, I want to be on TV, or, you know, we'll probably go and try and find another line of work when this is all over with. So
they can do video podcasts. All right. Thank you very much, Scott Jones. Appreciate you joining us. It's FTVLive.com.